Hi everyone, my name is Kritika Singh and I'm a recovered COVID patient. Today I'm making this video to share my experiences and journey with COVID. So I would like to start off by requesting that if you know of anyone in your friend circle or relatives or close family members who has experienced this illness closely, please ask them to record their experience and spread it out as much as possible. Because you might not know that who it ends up helping. And even if there's a single person that your video helps get through this illness effectively, then it's worth the effort. Please, please do that. So let me just start off by, you must all be wondering that how I got infected. So let me just answer it out pretty bluntly. We do not know how. I was someone who was very paranoid about COVID. I never used to step out of the house. I was following all the guidelines, everything to the T, but I still ended up having this infection. And the only possible reason which I can think of is that maybe when we got the groceries or fruits and vegetables which we had at the house, maybe some portion of those things was not as properly cleaned. So that's the only possible thing which I can think of, but we're not really sure how I got infected. Going further, let me just talk about the symptoms which I had. And let me tell you that I had all the symptoms in phases. It wasn't like I had fever or throat infection and it got okay in 4 or 5 days and I was back to normal. I majorly had all the symptoms, but they came in phases. Let me tell you how. So it started with a severe throat infection. I had a lot of pain in my throat. I could not talk properly. Along with that, I had congestion also. Then fever followed. But it wasn't a very high fever. It was little below 100, but it was consistent for 5 or 6 days. Wasn't increasing, it wasn't decreasing, but close to 100. Along with all this, I had severe fatigue and a body ache. Like taking a bath was like an exercise for me. That was very difficult. I could not lift up the bucket or anything. So that was pretty unusual for me because I have had viral earlier also, but so much of body ache I've never experienced. I could not move. I had pain in my joints. Then after 5 or 6 days, my throat pain got away because I took antibiotics for that, because that's the first instance which comes to your mind that you need to take antibiotics for your throat infection. And it got okay, and we thought it was just viral because the antibiotics work, and I felt better. But after that, after 5 or 6 days, I completely lost my sense of taste and smell. I could not taste food. I could not smell any fragrance. Strongest of fragrances, I could not smell at all. 100%, it was gone. That was a shocker for me because I had never ever experienced anything like that earlier. That is the time I thought maybe it's not just a common flu or viral, it's something else. And I had this fear of COVID in my mind throughout. Then we decided that I need to get tested, and we booked a test, and those people came home. They followed every precaution, every guideline. They wore a PPE kit, and everything was done very systematically. They did a swab test in which they insert a elongated cotton bud like thing in your nose very deeply, and also in your throat. They took that sample, and my reports came out the next day, and unfortunately they were positive. It was a shocker for me. The level of mental stress was beyond boundaries, and my heart was racing like anything. That was a very dreadful experience of my life, that moment when it came out to be positive. Then what followed was my breathing difficulty. After 4 or 5 days of experiencing the loss of taste and smell, which there still is right now, I haven't recovered. My reports are negative, but I cannot still taste a few items whose flavor is not too strong. So probably that comes back pretty slowly. That's what I have experienced. When I felt some difficulty in breathing, I was even more scared and I spoke to the doctor. That is when we got an oximeter at home, which tests your oxygen level. So I would recommend that please buy one and keep a check on your oxygen levels. It wasn't too expensive. It was in the range of 2500 to 3000, and you can get it from your chemist nearby, I believe. So please keep it at home. What followed was a course of treatment, and I would like to talk about that in detail. And please, please listen to it carefully. You need to take a vitamin C supplement. Even if you're having lemon water at home, lemon juice, amla, anything, but you need vitamin C supplement, because the quantity of vitamin C supplied by it cannot be replaced by your normal fruits or citrus fruits around you. Secondly, you need to take a multivitamin to maintain your energy levels, and so that you don't feel a lot of weakness, which COVID does. It breaks down the proteins in your body. You end up feeling very weak, very out of energy. So please, you need to take a multivitamin. Thirdly, please keep sipping hot water throughout the day. It's very important. Just take a bottle or a flask, fill it up with hot water, and carry it around the house wherever you are. Keep sipping it. Aim to drink at least 2 to 3 liters of water daily, so that if you have any soreness in your throat, it just goes away and your immunity is not affected too much. Fourthly, you need to take steam. I know the weather is pretty hot these days, and having hot water or taking steam daily is a task, but times are such that you have to do that. Please do that. Please take turmeric water daily. Just warm a little water, add a pinch of turmeric to it. That helps a lot in building your immunity. Then I also had Ayush ka kaadha, which had pepper, long dalchini, I think those flavors were there, I'm not too sure, but it had all the herbs that you find in the kitchen, which you normally take when you have a bad throat or congestion. So please take that kaadha, or you can, you know, brew it up in your kitchen also. Just read up any recipe on YouTube and add long dalchini, ginger, sauve to it. Whatever herb that suits your throat, please add everything together. Just make a concoction of it and have it. And you need to eat a lot of fresh fruits and vegetables, of course, properly cleaned, sanitized under hot water. Stop having junk food, sugar or maida. Reduce the quantities as much as possible. And all these measures can only help you to build up your immunity. They can never guarantee if you can, you know, if you won't contract COVID, but they'll surely reduce the impact which COVID has, you know, the severe symptoms. And I just request you to please do not wait for any illness to happen to you, and only then you would follow these guidelines and restrictions. Please follow it right now as soon as you see this, and please spread out this word, share this video, or share the learnings at least. But try that it reaches as many people as possible, because every experience matters and every experience of COVID is different. Thank you.